Hello student, very good morning to everyone. So in the last lecture we have started with the new chapter, that is chapter number 1.3, and the name of that chapter is pharmacodynamic agents. So in the last lecture we had learned the synthesis of amphetamine. So this is the synthesis of that amphetamine. Its synthesis start with phenylacetic acid. So at higher temperature the acetylation reaction takes place, followed by decarboxylation and hydrolysis, dehydration. It's a dehydration reaction, and you will get phenyl acetone, and the IUPAC name of that phenyl acetone is 1-phenylpropane-2-1, and then this phenyl acetone undergoes reaction with the treatment of this phenylacetone with hydroxylamine hydrochloride in presence of NaOH. You will get this oxime, then this oxime undergoes reduction, so you will get this amphetamine. But the what this amphetamine is, here you are getting the racemic mixture of your amphetamine, because this sodium in presence of MEOH methanol is not a selective reducing reagent. So from this to this step, so this after reduction you will get the mixture, that is the racemic mixture, the hydrogen, the here what this carbon is a chiral carbon, so this hydrogen can add from top side as well as bottom side. So you will get the mixture of product, that is the racemic mixture. And you know that we require only dextro form, that is D-amphetamine. We require only D-amphetamine. So today we are going to learn the asymmetric synthesis of D-amphetamine, because we want the chiral, only one molecule, only one chiral, only one optically active compound, that is D-amphetamine. And that should be in a 100% enantiomeric excess, not in a 50-50%. We want only one enantiomer, that is D-amphetamine. And you know that the dextro form is more potent than levo form, so that's why we want only this D-amphetamine. The synthesis of this D-amphetamine is started with this 1-phenylpropane-2-1 with S1-phenylethane-1-amine, and this is the IUPAC name, and the common name of this ketone is, it's a phenyl acetone, and it is on treatment with alpha methyl benzylamine. Then this, the treatment of this with when these two compound heated in presence of Ra-ni nickel and H2, you will get this compound, that is this compound you will get. Then the next step is this compound undergoes reduction, that is the breaking of this bond, or it is also called as hydrogenolysis, because you are breaking this CN bond, that's what is called as, not a reduction, it is called as hydrogenolysis, because you are breaking CN bond in presence of 10% PDC palladium carbon, palladium coated on carbon, H2 and MUH, so methanol, and you will get 100% enantiomeric excess of D-amphetamine. So its synthesis is very simple one. This phenyl acetone on treatment with chiral, this molecule is chiral because this carbon is attached to four different groups, so chiral alpha methyl benzylamine result into the formation of imine, and which was on reduction with Ra-ni nickel to give this compound first. This is compound first, then the hydrogenolysis of this N benzyl group, the hydrogenolysis of this CN bond takes place over 10% PDC, give D-amphetamine of high optical purity, 100% optical purity. So we'll see the reaction mechanism, how this enantiomeric excess of this D-amphetamine has been synthesized. So we'll see its reaction mechanism. For that I have to close this and we'll go to our chem draw and I have to change the orientation of this page from portrait to landscape, because portrait, in portrait we'll get the page is large size, so it is easy for me to write the structure of the compound. So you know that this D-amphetamine is you already know the uses. It is used in the treatment of obesity, appetite. It is also used in the treatment of narcolepsy and alcoholism. So in reaction mechanism, what happened? Your your phenyl acetone. So the structure of phenyl acetone is like this benzene ring, then it having this CH2, here double bond will be there. So this is your phenyl acetone. Alpha methyl benzylamine. So we need this ring and CH3. This is your, here is your NH2 CH3. So the reaction of these two molecule takes place, that is phenyl acetone and alpha methyl benzylamine, in presence of first these two compound is heated at a high temperature. So then that nitrogen is attached to your benzene ring. So this is your methyl group and now this is the complete structure. Okay, now here the hydrogen, this one hydrogen. Now there will be the positive charge on nitrogen, because now it nitrogen having four bonds, so we have to write the positive charge on nitrogen. Now this structure is unstable because the nitrogen having four bond. So to stabilize this nitrogen, this oxygen anion, it takes hydrogen from this nitrogen. Okay, and it takes the hydrogen and it stabilize this nitrogen. So in the next structure will be there will be no positive charge and hydrogen will join to this oxygen. So here we have CH3, 3, here also this is CH3, H, 2, N, N. So this carbon nitrogen double bond base. So once you get this shape base, the next step is a reduction of this carbon nitrogen double bond by Ranney nickel H2 and HCl. Ranney nickel in presence of H2 and HCl. So the reduction will be arrow, and we are reducing this in presence of nickel H. This solid line represents the bond towards you or above the plane of paper. So this higher, and this dashed line represent this group is away from you or below the plane of paper. So this hydrogen added from top side, not from a back side. So this is very important one. This is the selectivity of your reducing reagent. It selectively adds this hydrogen on top side, okay, not from bottom side. So the hydrogen add from top side, that's why you are getting only one enantiomer, okay. But you'll get only one enantiomer. So this is your enantiomer, that is in the next step is hydrogenolysis in presence of H 2 and O H. Now the role of this 10% PDC palladium coated on carbon is that the role of this 10% PDC is what? It do the hydrogenolysis. It breaks the carbon nitrogen bond. So it breaks this carbon nitrogen bond from here. These two hydrogen, one hydrogen add to this molecule, and one hydrogen add to this molecule. You will get amphetamine and ethyl benzene. So the third addition, the product will be. This one. So ethyl benzene and amphetamine. Ethyl benzene and amphetamine. This is in 100% enantiomeric excess. So by this synthesis, asymmetric synthesis of D amphetamine, you will get only one enantiomer, that is D enantiomer or dextro enantiomer. So the synthesis is very simple one. Your phenyl acetone react with this alpha methyl benzylamine. The nitrogen having lone pair of electron, that lone pair of electron will attack on the carbonyl carbon of this phenyl acetone. The phenyl acetone, the carbonyl carbon having two bond, one pi bond and one sigma bond, that pi bond will break and the bond pair shift on oxygen. So we are writing that as a negative charge, oxygen anion. then this oxygen anion takes hydrogen from this quaternary nitrogen, because that nitrogen having positive charge and it is unstable. So this your oxygen anion takes hydrogen and it stabilizes that nitrogen. Then next step is simply it's a removal of water molecule. So this OH takes this hydrogen, the bond will shift here, and simply the leaving of H2O. Leaving group is H2O, simply the loss of water molecule, and you will get this ship base carbon nitrogen double bond. This functional group is called as ship base. And once you get this ship base, the next step is reduction of this ship base in presence of rani nickel, in presence of H2N HCl. So this rani nickel and H2N HCl, it's a selective reducing agent. It adds this hydrogen only from top side, not from a bottom side. And the reason is what? Bottom side you are having this it adds the hydrogen only from top side. And one more reason is due to this the hydrogen adds from only top side. So this reagent rani nickel, it's a selective reducing reagent. It adds the hydrogen only from top side, and it reduces this carbon nitrogen double bond. One hydrogen will add to this carbon, and one hydrogen will add to this nitrogen, convert to HNH. So this NH convert to, so this nitrogen convert to NH, and this carbon convert to CH. So it's a reduction addition of hydrogen to this carbon nitrogen double bond, and it's a selective hydrogenation reaction. It's a selective hydrogenation reaction in presence of rani nickel and H2. So this rani nickel is a selective reducing reagent. It adds the hydrogen only from top side, and it reduces that. The next step is the breaking of this CN bond by using 10% PDC. That reaction is called as hydrogenolysis of N-benzyl group. By using 10% PDC, use D-amphetamine of high optical purity, because you are getting only one enantiomer, that is D-amphetamine, okay, of high optical purity. So the role of this 10% PDC is that it breaks selectively the carbon nitrogen bond. So here the so many bonds are there, but it selectively breaks the CN bond. That reaction is called as hydrogenolysis reaction, and it's a selective hydrogenolyting agent. It selectively breaks CN bond, so you will get only this D-amphetamine. And as you know that this amphetamine is having two amphetamine, it is optically active, and it observed that the only dextro form is found to be more potent than levo form. And this is in a levo form, then it will not be a optically active, because only dextro form is optically active. And why it is D form? Because we have to number it 1, 2, 3. So it rotating in an anti-clockwise, but the hydrogen is on top side. So this, the configuration changes from S to R. The rotation is 1, 2, 3, like this. One hydrogen, one this CH2, 2, and this CH3, 3. 1, 2, 3, and hydrogen 4. But the hydrogen is on top side, so that's why the configuration changes from S to R. So R means D, and you know that you will get this D amphetamine. Okay. So this is all about the synthesis of amphetamine, and so take a look at this. And wait, I have to charge this PC. I have to charge my laptop. So as you know that in the bioavailability, we had learned the factor affecting the bioavailability. So in that, the one factor is there, that is if the chiral compound is there, if you are using a racemic mixture, then the bioavailability is in case of chiral molecule, if you are using racemic mixture, then the bioavailability will be less than 50%, because the only one of the optical isomer will be biologically active. So same the case is here, because you are having racemic mixture, that is D and L, but the only dextro isomer is optically active, so the bioavailability is 50%, because the another enantiomer is biologically inactive. So this is the structure of amphetamine, D amphetamine, and this T amphetamine used in the treatment of narcolepsy, alcoholism, obesity, and appetite. So this is all about the synthesis of D amphetamine. The reaction mechanism is very simple. It synthesis start with this phenylacetone, imprint some this alpha methyl benzylamine, then this nitrogen having lone pair of electron, that lone pair of electron will attack on the carbonyl carbon, the bond will break, negative charge on oxygen, this anion takes proton, stabilizes nitrogen, then the simply the loss of water molecule, hydrolysis reaction, then it will get the shift base carbon nitrogen, double bond containing species, then the next step is the reduction, selective reduction, hydrogen add only from top side, the N will convert to NH, then C will convert to CH, will get this product after reduction, then the hydrogenolysis reaction, that is the breaking of CN bond, in presence of PDC, it selectively break this CN bond, and you will get this ethyl benzene and D amphetamine with 100% EE for enantiomeric excess, because you are having one enantiomer in an excess, that is 100% enantiomeric excess. So this is all about the synthesis of amphetamine and its reaction mechanism. So in the previous synthesis, we have learned the two synthesis, that is amphetamine. So in the previous one, we are getting the, what you can say, that we are getting the racemic mixture, because this reduction is not a selective reduction. The hydrogen add from both the side, top side as well as bottom side. That's why this first method is not useful, because the only one enantiomer is one enantiomer is biologically active, so this first one is not useful. While in this one, in this step, you are getting only one enantiomer, that is the enantiomer. So second one is most important than the first one, because in the first one you are getting racemic mixture, two enantiomer, and you know that in the bioavailability, if your racemic mixture is used, then the bioavailability will be only 50%, because one enantiomer is biologically inactive. So that's why the second method is most useful than the first one. This is all about that reaction mechanism. So here in this step, the nitrogen in reaction mechanism, it will generate the carbanion, and that carbanion, it can attack from the hydrogen can add from both sides, top side as well as bottom side. So it is not a useful method for the so synthesis of amphetamine because you are getting the racemic mixture. And while the second one, this one is the second one, you are getting d-amphetamine, only one enantiomer in a XXS form. So that's why the second method is most useful. You are getting 100% enantiomeric excess. Reaction is very simple, it is only in a two step, while in the first one it requires first, second, third, it required 3-4 steps, while here the reaction complete in a two step. The time required for the second reaction is less as compared to first one, and in the first one you require so many reagents, you have to heat that at high temperature acetylation, then you have to prepare the oxime, then reduction, and the one more method is you are using sodium, and you know that the sodium is explosive. So I think this can't do this reaction in a lab because the sodium is highly explosive, and the explosion may take place. So this reaction is what very dangerous, because this step is very dangerous. And once this, you know that the once the hydrogen the sodium when come in contact with water, the explosion takes place. So this method will not be useful for the synthesis of amphetamine on a large scale, while this one is very good if we are not using any dangerous reagent in the synthesis, and we are getting 100% enantiomeric excess of T-amphetamine. So we have learned its reaction mechanism. Then thank you.